Ibrahim alayhi salam, he receives a commandment and an order from Allah to leave his children in the desert and to go off to Palestine. Where are they? They're in Mecca. There is no living being there. There's no animals there. There's no vegetation there. It's a hot, dry desert. And he's leaving his wife and his son, the baby Ismail, in this kind of environment. Yani, or he's leaving him in certain death. That's how it looks like. As he walks out of Mecca, going towards Palestine, he makes a dua and he says, Rabbi, إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم. He says, oh Allah, I have left my family. I have left them. Where? بواد, in a valley. غير ذي زرع, in a place, in a valley where there is absolute no vegetation. What's the first dua he makes? He says, ربنا ليقيم الصلاة. Oh Allah, allow them to be from those who establish a salat. Then after that he says, وَرْزُقْهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ, provide for them some provision so they can eat and drink. That wasn't his first dua for his family. He didn't then say, oh Allah, provide for them. Oh Allah, feed them. Oh Allah, rescue them and save them from starvation and thirst. That wasn't the first dua. The first one, رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Oh Allah, allow them to establish this salat and allow the meanings of salat to penetrate deep in their heart. Because if that's the case, a rizq is going to come. Provision will come. You don't have to worry about that. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself was no different. When Allah azza wa jal commanded to him, he said to him, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. He says to him, and enjoin, encourage, advise your family, بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا, and be patient concerning your advice and commandment to them of a salat. لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ. We do not ask you for any provision. You don't have to provide for anyone. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ. Allah will give a rizq. In other words, a salat is one of the main reasons for why one earns his rizq. How does it make sense now? When one goes to work, or some of us are not here for salat al-jum'ah. Why? Because we're at work. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying to you, a salat is the reason for your source of provision. And until you've turned the meanings upside down for those that don't attend their salat al-jum'ah and those that try to bunch up all the salawat at the end of the day, you made it like your rizq was your work and a salat had nothing to do with that. For subhanAllah, we need to be very conscious of these meanings.